This is a video on mathematics for the students of class 9, and we are discussing chapter 6, that is problems on simultaneous linear equations. In the previous video, we had started with exercise 6, the first part of the video. Today we shall continue with that exercise. So the first question that we are discussing from chapter 6 today is, if from twice the greater of the two numbers 16 is subtracted, the result is half the other number. Now remember, we have two number. One of the number is greater and other one is a smaller number than the previous one. Now if from twice the greater of the two numbers 16 is subtracted, that means twice the greater, that means we have two times of x. If I subtract 16 from that, the result is half the other number. So we know that smaller number we've taken as y. So half of the smaller number, that is 2x minus 16, is equal to y by 2. Now we have two numbers. From that, twice the greater of the two numbers, 16 is subtracted. So you have 2x. If 16 is subtracted, so 2x minus 16, the result that we get is half the other number. So other number is y. So half will be y by 2. Now we need to form an equation. So I've taken y by 2 this side, so it becomes 2x minus y by 2. On solving this, you get something like this: 4x minus y, which is equal to 32. So this is what the first condition is stating. Now in the second part, we have, if from half the greater number 1 is subtracted, the result is still half the other number. Now if half of the greater number, the greater number is x, if from that half of this number 1 is subtracted, so x minus 2 minus 1 is also giving us y by 2. So when you solve this, you get x minus y, which is equal to 2. So this is what second equation states. Now since we formed two equations, 4x minus y equal to 32 and x minus y is equal to 2 is your second equation. Now on subtracting equation 2 from 1, we get 4x minus x minus y is equal to 32 and x minus y is equal to 2. Here we see that since y is identical term here, so when we subtract this, so this becomes plus y, so plus minus is 0, so you don't have any variable with y. Here we are left with 4x minus x, which is equal to 3x. 32 minus 2 gives us 30. So value of x comes up to 10. On substituting the value of x in equation 2, which is x minus y is equal to 2. So we'll be putting the value of x and trying to find out the value of y in equation 2. So on putting this, you get y is equal to 8. That means the two numbers are 10 and 8. Now if the equation, you can solve it according to the conditions, you'll get the same answer here. Second question is, there are 38 points in a collection and 20 in a collection of 20 paise coins and 25 paise coins. Now we are given 20 paise coins and 25 paise coins. Now you must remember that when we are discussing sums related to rupee, we have number of coins and value of coins. Now there stands a difference, because if I take 2 20 paise coins, it is costing only 50 paise, but 2 25 paise coins make it 50 paise. So there's a difference in the value. So we need to understand this when we are making. So to make 20 paise coin 1 rupee, we need 5 coins, right, to make it 1 rupee. But 25 coins, we need 4 coins only. So there is a difference in the value when I take the number of coins. So we have to be careful. So we can say, to make 2 rupees, we need total 9 coins, right? Now let's not get confused with that. Let us only keep 20 paise coins as x and 25 paise coins as y. Now we have total number of coins, that is 38 coins. Now we have to actually find how many coins are there. So they've given us two conditions, and first condition is stating that total number of 20 paise coins and total number of 25 paise coins is actually equal to 38. That is, In a simple sentence, if I say the total number of coins that we have is equal to 38. Now, second condition, they are stating that the total value of the collection is rupees 8.5. Now, this number of coins has been converted in terms of rupee, which is total of 8.5. Now, we have to find out how many 20 paise coins and how many 25 paise coins is making up 8.50. Now, we do not know the value. So, what we do is, since we know that there is a 20 paise coin and we are assuming that there are X number of 20 paise coins, that means X number of 20 paise coins plus X into 25 number of 25 paise Y into 25 paise coins should give us rupees 8.50. So actually we are multiplying the number of, like if I say how many, if I say 5 rupees, 10 number of coins, you have 10 coins and I'm telling you that you have 5 rupee coins only and the total number of coins that you have is 10. Now all the coins are of rupee 5, so what is the amount that you have? So what do we do? 5 paise coins are there and they are 10 in number. So 5 into 10 gives us 50 rupees. So you can see the value of coins that is with you is rupees 50. Similarly, we have been stated that we have X number of coins and all the coins are 20 paise. So total value of the 20 paise coins is 20 paise coins into X. So we can write that as 0.20X. Similarly, we have 25 paise coins and the number of coins is Y. So we can write down that as 0.25 because this is in paise, not in rupee. And number of coins that we have is Y. So we can write down that as 0.25Y. Now total value that we have is 8.50. So we have X plus Y is equal to 38, 0.20X plus 0.25Y is equal to 8.50. So we've got our two equations. Now we'll be solving with the same simultaneous equation. Now subtracting equation 1 from 2, this is how it is formed. Now to convert it into uniform, we'll multiply your equation 1 with 0.20. So you get something like this. So 0.20x and 0.20x, this gets cancelled on subtracting. So you're left with 0.05. So which gives us 0.09 as our answer. So y is equal to 18. That means total number of 25 paise coins is 18. Now we know that total number of coins, you can find out the value of X, and total number of coins we know is 38. Since X plus Y is equal to 38, so we know that Y is 18. So we can just write down that X is equal to 38 minus 18, which is equal to 20. Meaning to say that there are 20 20 paise coins and 18 25 paise coins. So if when you multiply 20 into 0.20 plus 18 into 0.25, you will get your answer as 8.5. Also, you can check. Be careful with the number of coins and value of coins. This is sometimes very confusing, but if once you've understood this, you can easily solve them. So this is all we have from the video today. Thank you.